Hello everyone, welcome to another series of To The Point. Today's topic of discussion is coral bleaching. First of all, let's see why is it in the news. Scientists working on Australia's Great Barrier Reef have successfully trialed a new method for freezing and storing coral larvae. They say could eventually help rewild reefs threatened by climate change. Now let's discuss what are coral reefs. Corals are marine invertebrates or animals not possessing a spine. Each coral is called a polyp, and thousands of such polyps live together to form a colony. They grow when polyps multiply to make copies of themselves. Corals share a symbiotic relationship with single-celled algae called zooxanthellae. The algae provides the coral with food and nutrients, which they make through photosynthesis using the sun's light. In turn, the corals give the algae a home and key nutrients. The zooxanthellae also gives corals their bright color. Now let's understand what is coral bleaching. Coral bleaching happens when corals experience stress in their environment due to changes in temperature, pollution, or high levels of ocean acidity. Under stressed conditions, the zooxanthellae or food-producing algae living inside coral polyps start producing reactive oxygen species which are not beneficial to the corals. So the corals expel the color-giving zooxanthellae from their polyps. It exposes their pale white exoskeleton, giving the corals a bleached appearance. This also ends the symbiotic relationship that helps the corals to survive and grow. Now let's have a look at the causes of coral bleaching. Changes in ocean temperature caused by climate change. When temperatures are high, high solar irradiance contributes to bleaching in shallow water corals. Exposure to the air during extremely low tides can cause bleaching in shallow corals, ocean acidification, and increased sedimentation. Now lastly, let's discuss about Australia's Great Barrier Reef. Australia's Great Barrier Reef is the world's largest reef system stretching across 2,300 km. It hosts 400 different types of coral, gives shelter to 1,500 species of fish and 4,000 types of mollusk. The reef is located in the Coral Sea, northeast coast, off the coast of Queensland, Australia. It was selected as a World Heritage Site in 1981. Now it's time for the practice question. Consider the following statements regarding the coral reefs. 1. Corals are marine invertebrates or animals not possessing a spine. 2. Australia's Great Barrier Reef is the world's largest reef system. Which of the above given statement or statements is or are not correct? 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2, or neither 1 nor 2? Send the answer of this question in the comment section. Stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Dear viewers, watch this topic in Hindi on our Drishti IAS Hindi YouTube channel.